Hello students, we have learned about reflection of light. Now we are going to study another phenomenon of light, that is refraction of light. Up to this we learned that light travels along straight line path in a transparent medium, that may be air, water, glass. Light follows straight line path. But what happens when light enters from one transparent medium to another? Does it still move along a straight line path or changes direction? We shall recall some of our day-to-day life experiences to understand this. Students, you might have observed that bottom of a tank or swimming pool appears to be raised, as you can see in this picture. Also, a glass slab is placed over some printed matter. The letters appear raised. A pencil, partly immersed in a glass of water, appears to be displaced at the interface or boundary of air and water. Here you can see the pencil appears displaced at the interface of air and water. Why does it happen? See, in case of pencil partly immersed in water, the light reaching us from the portion of pencil inside the water seems to come from the different direction as compared to the part above water. This makes the pencil appear displaced at the interface of air and water. Same reason is there for bottom of tank and letters appear to be raised. All these observations indicate that when light travels obliquely, means making an angle from one transparent medium to another, the direction of light changes in second medium, and this phenomena is known as refraction of light. So we can say that due to refraction of light, pencil appears bent, letters appear raised. How we can define this refraction? We can define refraction as bending of light at the boundary separating two media when it travels from one medium to another. You can see in this diagram also, here one medium is air medium and another one is water. This is the incident ray which travels from air medium to water medium. At this point of incidence, at this boundary of air and water medium, the bending of light takes place, and this bending of light is called as refraction of light. We can also define it as change in the direction of light at the boundary separating two media when it passes from one transparent medium to another obliquely is called as refraction. Now, the question arises, what is the cause of refraction? Why refraction takes place when light enters from one medium to another? The answer is, refraction takes place due to change in speed of light. Light has different speed in different medium. So, speed of light in air medium is different and speed of light in water medium is different. As light enters from one medium to another, its speed changes, and due to this change in speed, refraction takes place. Here, the medium refers to any transparent substance or material from which light can pass. We have two types of mediums, rare and denser medium. Rare medium is a medium which has less optical density and speed of light is more in this medium. So rare medium means the medium in which speed of light is more and which has less optical density. Students, optical density is different from the normal density. You know about the normal density, which is related to heaviness or lightness of material. And it is measured as mass per unit volume. We learn this in 9th class also. But optical density is how much a material is able to slow down the light or we can say that it is a ability to slow down the transmission of light. So optical density means the ability to slow down the transmission of light. And rare medium is having less optical density. It can't slow down the transmission of light, and so in this medium speed of light is more. For example, in this case, air is the rare medium and water is the denser medium. Next type of medium is denser medium. It is the medium which has more optical density and speed of light is lesser in this medium. Water is denser than the air in the example or in this previous example. Means what? Water is having more ability to slow down the transmission of light than water. Here, one more example we can take, water and oil. Now, in air and water case, water is denser than air. But if we will take water and oil, then optical density of water is less than the oil, and so oil is denser medium than the water, and in that case water is rarer than the oil. So here we are having two types of medium, rare medium or denser medium. Here are some important terms of refraction of light. Incident ray, this we know very well, that is the ray that strikes the surface or which get incident on the surface is called as incident ray. Point of incidence, point where the incident ray strikes the surface, the point at which the incident ray strikes the surface. Refracted ray is the ray that changes its path when it travels from one medium to another. So refracted ray is this ray which get deviated, which get refracted, or which changes its path when travels from one medium to another. Normal ray, as you know, it is a perpendicular drawn to the point of incidence. Angle of incidence is the angle between normal and incident ray, and angle of refraction is the angle between refracted ray and the normal. Students, now we'll see how refraction takes place when light passes from denser to rare medium and rare to denser medium. Now see the first case, refraction when light passes from denser to rare medium. When light travels from denser to rare medium, its speed increases and light bends away from the normal. So we can see here, this water is the denser medium and air is the rare medium. When light incident or travel from water to air medium, that is from denser to rare medium, it moves away from the normal. This is the normal drawn. And in this case, the angle of incidence is smaller than the angle of refraction. So when light travels from denser to rare medium, its speed increases and light bends away from the normal. And in this case, angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incidence. You can remember this like Dr. Away, means denser to rare, away from the normal. And when light passes from rare to denser medium, its speed decreases and light bends towards the normal. So in this case, we can see light passes from air to water medium, that means from rare to denser medium, and so in refracted ray bend towards the normal. In this case, angle of incidence is greater than angle of refraction. And speed of light decreases in this medium. In third case is when light incident normally on the second medium. When the incident light is normal to the second medium, दो लाइट ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम वन मीडियम टू अनदर बेंडिंग ऑफ लाइट डज नॉट टेक्स प्लेस. दैट मीन्स नो रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट टेक्स प्लेस व्हेन लाइट ट्रेवल्स नॉर्मली. इन दिस केस एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एंड एंगल ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन इज जीरो. So remember all these three cases, that when light passes from denser to rarer medium, the refracted ray moves away from the normal. When light passes from rare to denser medium, it moves towards the normal. And when light ray falls normally, then there will be no refraction of light. So this is all about refraction of light. Hope you understood refraction of light and how light bends towards or away from the normal. Next is refraction through a rectangular glass slab to understand the phenomena of refraction of light. I will suggest you to read activity 10.10. In this activity, when light incident on a glass slab, a part of it get reflected and another part of light get refracted and travels inside the glass slab as shown in figure. So this is our rectangular glass slab ABCD. When light falls on this glass slab, some light will get reflected and some will get refracted through the glass slab. First, refraction takes place at the first surface AB. After first refraction, it falls on second side and get refracted again. So when light get incident, first refraction of light takes place at the first surface, then again second refraction takes place at the second surface. Now here we consider that incident ray PQ is incident on surface AB of glass slab at the point of incidence O. So this is the incident ray PQ which get incident at the point O. This is the point of incidence. If we draw a normal MN at the point of incidence, we will find ray PQ is making an angle of incidence with normal. So this is the normal MN at the point of incidence O. And we can see here this ray PQ has made one angle, that is angle of incidence with the normal. And as this incident ray travels from optically rarer to denser medium, that is from air to glass medium, on refraction this refracted ray bend towards the normal. Just now we discussed that when light ray incident from rare to denser medium, it moves towards the normal. So this PQ is a incident ray at the point of incidence O. It forms the angle of incidence, and then refracted ray OO dash forms the angle of refraction. It bend towards the normal. Here ray OO dash is the refracted ray. This refracted ray forms angle with the normal, that is angle of refraction. R1 is the angle of refraction between normal and refracted ray. So as this ray OO dash is traveling from AB to DC, at the surface DC we can draw another normal M1, N1 at the point of incidence, that is O dash. We can say that angle of incidence for this O dash ray at second surface is R2. So this R2 is the angle of incidence for this second surface. Now at second surface, light incidence from denser to rare medium, that is from glass to air medium, and so light will bend away from the normal. So in this case, at the second surface, light is getting incident from denser to rare medium, and so speed of light will increase and light will bend away from the normal after refraction. And it forms an angle E. So this is angle E. This angle is known as angle of emergence. This angle is known as angle of emergence. Now see what is happening over here. The incident ray PQ, if the glass slab would not have been there, the PQ would have traveled along straight line path. This path PQ would have traveled. But instead, when we place the glass slab, we find PQ is emerging from glass slab along RS. And due to this glass slab, it emerged along path RS in this direction. So, we can say path of light has been shifted. And this shift in path of light is known as lateral shift. And so, this shift in path of light is called as lateral shift. Lateral means sideways. So, due to glass slab, this incident ray shifted sideways. And this displacement, lateral displacement, is called as lateral shift. As we can see from the diagram, we can say emergent ray has been shifted from the original path of incident ray. So from this diagram, we can say this emergent ray is shifted from this original path of incident ray. The emergent ray is parallel to the incident ray because there is same medium, that is air. And AB and DC are parallel to one another. And thus, incident ray and emergent ray are parallel to one another as their medium is same, and also the same medium is there, and also AB and DC are also parallel to one another. That's why incident ray is parallel to the emergent ray. Students, from this activity we can conclude that the ray of light traveling from rarer to denser medium bends towards the normal. The ray of light traveling from denser to rarer medium bends away from the normal. And the emergent ray is parallel to the incident ray, but gets slightly displaced. And that slight displacement or lateral displacement is called as lateral shift. So this is refraction of light through rectangular glass slab. Here emergent ray means what? A ray that passes through a certain media and then returns to its original media is known as emergent ray. So here we can see this ray is passed from air medium and emerged again in the rarer medium. So this ray is called as emergent ray. Angle of emergence, the angle between normal ray and emergent ray, is called as angle of emergence. Lateral displacement can be defined as perpendicular shift in the path of incident ray when it travels through a certain medium and then return to its original medium. So this is refraction through rectangular glass slab. Experiment shows that refraction of light occurs according to certain laws known as laws of refraction. So, like laws of reflection, we are having laws of refraction also. These are the laws obeyed by the surface from where the refraction takes place. The statement of laws are, first one, the incident ray, normal ray and refracted ray all lie in the same plane. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always constant to a particular pair of media. That is, sine of angle of incidence by sine of angle of refraction is equal to constant, and that constant is denoted by N21. This law is also called as Snell's law of refraction. This is true for angle of incidence greater than 0 degree and smaller than 90 degree. So here this I is angle of incidence, R is angle of refraction, and the sine I by sine R is equal to constant, is equal to N21, where this N21 is known as refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. So this is all about refraction of light through rectangular glass slab and laws of refraction. In next video, we will learn about refractive index. Thank you and have a nice day.